What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today is Monday, June 13th, 2022. Thanks so much for tuning in. We're heading over to a job in South Valley Stream. Customer's got a Hayward pool heater.
Hayward. Did you blow me?
Nah, I'm all right. Maybe you leave it for that guy, that thing, that fluid neutral. No, that gender fluid individual.
Oh, the
outside the Oyo Hotel from last week.
The transmission.
The transmission.
BDK.
BDK.
Maybe.
Hey. BDK. Bombs away. You know what? I should send him to BDK. Definitely. Anyway, Hayward heat pump pool heater that's acting up. No power. Last time we were there was in 2016. So I guess we'll be fixed or good. So much for job security, but our sticker is on it, so we're going back there. And on the way there, we're going to stop by and get some King Umberto's. So stay tuned. Christian, look. We're approaching Meacham Avenue. You know what? You know what's at the corner of Meacham Avenue and Hempstead Turnpike, right? KU.
You've arrived. Destination is on your left.
KU, baby! Oh, KU. Oh, King Umberto.
Special exemption?
Variance. I want a variance.
I don't know what that means.
Oh, what's wrong with this guy? Hey.
Give him a break. He's retarded.
Shh. You can't say that. It's not politically correct.
You get canceled. Give him a break. He's special needs.
Special needs. Oh, special needs. Stepsister. We'll park right here.
Oh, you curbed him.
I curbed him. Christian, are you hungry?
Very.
How hungry are you? How many slices do you think you can eat?
Three, four.
Four?
Yeah.
You gonna get four slices right now?
No, I'm not gonna get four. I still gotta work, you know?
Oh, come on. Be like a fat fuck like your father. Look at that. Epic. Damn.
Good old King Umberto.
Oh, it was open the whole time!
Yeah.
No, my
hands like...
My big ass
girl
out of the
hands.
Way.
Let's show them.
I didn't have my ass slid all the way in the seat.
Can we show them the KU?
Yeah, we can show them. Hold on, safety first.
Safety first. Yeah.
Click at her ticket.
Click at her ticket.
Oh, KU.
And they said it's a fresh pie, too.
Oh.
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 Oh. Oh. Oh. It's like orgasmic, by the way. Wow. All right, Chris. Divvy her up. You're going to mess it up. You're going to let it cool off.
I'll try it again. It was only 10 seconds.
Try it again. You know, pull the sleeves. Burn the roof of your mouth.
Oh, what was that? Oh, it was not worth it.
It's not worth it?
It was worth it.
It's worth it. You got KU'd. I'm letting mine cool off a little bit more. As we drive to South Valley Stream, North Woodmere, to fix a Hayward heat pump. So stay tuned, guys. Hope we got you to laugh a little bit.
Oh.
Once you stop, you can't stop. Oh, it's like ladies just can't have one.
Oh.
Hayward. Where's the power panel?
Yeah. Right
here?
Yep.
That doesn't move. There's a trick.
It's filled with water. So, there is no power, by the way.
Oh, there's no power there?
Yeah. No. Something happened to the heater. There is no power.
Ah, okay, understood. All right, Chris, grab the tool bag and grab the little kneeling mat, please.
Power is over.
How old is this?
This is pretty old heater. It's like
10 years.
And I'm planning to replace it
next year with
natural gas one.
So okay.
We need to leave for this season.
All right, let's see if we can fix it for you.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll see. Okay. fuse is blown. Why is the fuse blown? All right, let's see if we have voltage to transform. We're gonna pull power. Let's see what's going on inside this bad boy. No, oh, it's nothing. Ooh. It's not used.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah.
Pour that up.
Crazy. All right, let's look inside. Looking for a short and... Is that one right there? Yep. There it is.
Oh yeah.
Right there. That's the, looks like the low pressure switch. The two blue wires. Right there. There you go. There's your short.
Well, it looks like that was done on purpose.
Yeah, it's kind of stupid, but all right. Yep.
So let's get these out of here. Gotta run some new wire. Yeah, pull both those wires out of there. Gotta run new wire. Alright, so used a couple Wagos as the wire connector from the low pressure switch. Ran some new wire through here and we'll feed it through the chase into the control board. Alright, next we're gonna redo condenser fan motor wiring because that's how they did it there. Not too bright. I guess they like electric tape. So the wiring is kind of short, so it goes all the way down then it comes back up again. That's probably why they did it like this. Okay. Let's get the step bit. We'll drill a hole here and route our wires through the new hole. All right, there's the ground for the condenser fan motor. I re-spliced. I put our new bay connectors on those. We drilled a hole, put a plastic grommet there. I made a hole, but that was too big. And now I just gotta wire up my condenser fan motor. Now they have plenty of room in. Get rid of all these nonsense. All right, all the wires. There's the condenser fan motor contactor, missing the cover, of course. Capacitor.
Is there some loose wire over there?
Loose wire over there?
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah, where do you see loose wire?
No, that would be the ground.
That'd be the other ground.
Yeah.
Yeah. Another ground.
It's put into plastic at first. Yeah.
This one is coming from right here to this group.
This is ground as well.
This is a ground.
Well, that's what I'm saying, but it's not connected enough.
No. Alright. Let's turn power on.
Okay. Be careful.
Chris, I would not lean on top of it when you press power on.
Touching plastic anyway, it's not conductive.
And there we go. H1, 2.2, the dots. PS, pressure switch.
Yeah, I need to turn.
You need to turn the pumps on.
Yeah, pumps on. Should I do it?
If you want this to turn on,
yeah. Yeah.
See what the temperature of his water is.
It takes a minute.
Let's go measure his temperature of his pool. All right, let's measure the pool temperature. We'll do it at a skimmer. Okay. And we are around 76 degrees and a half. Not bad. Where are the steps?
Oh, there they are. Yep, 76.4.
A lot of vibration, probably because the speed. The fan blade is at the bottom of the shaft, and the wobbling the whole thing around. Damn! Look at that. I know I'm watching the phone. So you're killing the motor. You want us to fix that? We're gonna take the thing off and lower the fan blade and then cut it. But you're killing the motor.
Hear that shroud?
Yeah, it's designed to. A lot of wobble. Well, start over or let it be.
If it's quick, then you can attend some meeting for 10
minutes. No, not gonna be more than 10 minutes. Okay. All right, let's put the cover back on, Chris. I'll check the temperature. Wow, now it's 69 degrees in there. It's cold water. Let's check a supply, one of the jets. There's one right there. Let's see what we have here coming out. All right, I have the tip of the thermocouple in there. Looks like we're warming up. 76 and climbing. That's a good thing. All right. And again, it's cold in here. 69 degrees, it's cold. And another reason why I like to document my service calls with video is, if this guy can't tell me next week, next month, next year, like, hey, you know, you killed the condenser fan motor. I gave him the opportunity to fix it, but he wanted to limit it on time. He goes, I got to be in a meeting in 10 minutes. I was like, well, I need a little bit longer than 10 minutes. I'm not going to be rushing through a job, you know? All right. If you work on these Hayward HeatPro heat pumps, I see this quite frequently. We have vibration from the machine. Normal vibration, not the vibration to the condenser fan motor, but that blue wire, right? The pair of blue wires, that's the low pressure switch. And let me tell you something, it touches over time, heats up, exposes the copper. Well, you're gonna have a short to ground and blow that fuse. Don't be a fuse changer. If you see a blown fuse, investigate the cause, the origin, just like I did in this video. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching this little heat pump repair video. Thanks for tuning in. Be well, God bless, stay safe.